the world needs to see a change. It started out as kind of anti-corporate, but I think it's kind of morphed here in LA into more of a conversation about how to fix the planet and ourselves, you know? The police brutality has been completely lacking here, which is an awesome gift, you know? So we've been using that to kind of start a garden over there. And a sovereign nation has popped up to deal with the indigenous peoples component to this, which, you know, they've seen the problems of capitalism for 500 years. So LA is unique.
I think it's the movement that I have been waiting for years and years, and it brings together many factions of the society, and for a cause that basically has to be visible, you know, because people are really, I think, frustrated of being unheard. So yeah, I'm here to experience it all and to see how I can really mobilize my resources to make it happen.
I think they're really clear that the Occupy movement is not just people who are camping here. They're anybody who considers themselves part of the movement is part of this movement.
I remember being really excited about the possibility of like being engaged in the political process, and over the last few years, the more I've learned, the more it seems that there are just sort of a few. You don't really get to be engaged in the political process because you're presented with the few choices with which you can engage, and that's not really true engagement. And if your engagement is to walk into a box and spend maybe 2 minutes pushing some switches, I mean, what does that really do? It does nothing.
I see it in my students. I teach middle school, and they don't have, they don't believe that whatever I was sold as a kid, in terms of you go to college, you get a good job, and you are a success. They don't really believe that's gonna happen. And I can't lie to them and say I believe it anymore either. So I do support this because it's actually a positive thing that people are saying something about it, because I think people have felt this for a long time.
I'm part of the Occupy movement because, in terms of my personal story, I went to graduate school with the hope of becoming a professor and with the hope of achieving the American dream. And now I'm $100,000 in debt. And there's a lot of people in this situation, I think, who have gone gotten higher educations and ended up, or even just college educations, and gotten into a lot of debt to come out into a job market that doesn't have anything for them.
Our politicians, our political leaders, both Democrats and Republicans, have made promises that they have not kept. They both promised to focus on jobs and unemployment, and what we get are talking points and programs that are inadequate, that don't really address the real issues that most people have to deal with, which are unemployment, the housing crisis, lack of health care, and what we get is a bunch of phony baloney.
I believe that there's a lot of inequality and a lot of problems in the world that need to be solved, and that if people get together and express their views, we can convince our leaders, our politicians, and even maybe our head businessmen that they could help to make things better for everybody instead of just for a few.
One of the things I was really excited to see today is that there are all these really smaller groups of people who are committed to particular issues, having dialogues with each other. And to me, that was a kind of cohesion that I haven't seen at other protests or other sort of meetings of the left in the last 10 or 12 years or so. It's felt like everything's been very fragmented, and here people are having discussions. We were talking with the librarian over in the library tent about people who just came in to read, and then they started this discussion about the things they were reading together, and that's really exciting to me.
I don't know how many people I talked with, but by the end of the first day, I was just like, oh my God, this day was incredible. I exchanged so many ideas with people, and I saw something that was really amazing to me, which speaks to why the movement will succeed, which is that two people started having a conversation thinking that they were agreeing, and then they discovered that no, we really disagree about some fundamental things, and they started yelling at each other, and they proceeded for several minutes to yell at each other, but then they stopped yelling at each other eventually, and they kept talking, and the more they talked, the more they realized that there were fundamental things that they agreed on, and those fundamental things that they agreed on were the things that they wanted to see change. And to me, that's kind of like the most important thing, and that's happening. That's happening in, you know, LA City Hall, it's happening in Long Beach, it's happening all over the country. So that's, I think that's why I could succeed. Yeah.
Part of what's exciting for me is that it's gaining a global momentum. I'm Taiwanese and I have family in Taiwan, and last weekend on Saturday, there was Occupy Taipei, and it was something that was done peacefully, and the Taiwanese people really know how to demonstrate themselves. So great demonstration going on in Taipei 101.
We have proposed the 28th Amendment to the Constitution to undo Citizens United, which is underlying a lot of the bad things that are happening politically, the flood of toxic money, which has poisoned our political environment. So we're campaigning for that, and that's very much in the spirit of Occupy, the Occupy movement.
Yeah.
I think that if we can keep our unity together, and if we can keep our messages together, that we can succeed, that we can convince people to loosen their wallets and hire more people in America, to bring some of the jobs back here, to stop giving away money to particularly corporations that may not necessarily need it, to do things like drill for oil in areas that they were going to drill in anyway.
It's not messaging, and it's not talking points. It's an honest investigation of what needs to happen. And I think that the search for direct democracy, you know, or stating that as an intention, then you reevaluate and reevaluate based on who's in the room, based on what's really going on, as opposed to people whose interests are not our own creating policy.
Why will it succeed? I've seen journalists writing saying that it already has. I think what we've done here is established a space for dialogue. And since no one's leaving, we've already won. These ideas are, the solutions to our problems are already in the philosophical and academic realm. So it's not about what our demands are. We know how to fix ourselves. It's about creating that space, empowering ourselves to do that, which means we've won.